beginning to creep me out, Arthur.
Hold still! Pearson said he shorted a little meat for the pot!
Stop it! This ain't funny!
Oh, I disagree! Now, why are you so afraid of a pair of Gelding tongs? I thought you were the horse
you
expert!
Ain't that.
My boy. Keep it coming. Thank you.
Hey there, Arthur.
Hey, fellas. I have a meeting with Mrs. Braithwaite. My associates are already here.
All right, that's enough. Move along now.
Please come in, sir. This way, sir. A gentleman to see you, ma'am.
So, your friend, the other liquor vendor. Hello.
Hello, ma'am.
Arthur, welcome. We're just playing cribbage. Arthur Morgan, Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
Nice to see you again.
Apparently. So this one, he is big and as dumb as he looks?
Well, he's surely big. But his intelligence is a matter of some conjecture. Some say he is as dumb as he looks, but I think, well, he's not quite that dumb.
So these are the boys going to Callagher Hall?
Yes, we can take care of that for you, but one hates to be coarse. There is the question of money.
Oh, we've got money, Mr. Matthews.
Paper, bonds, metal.
She ain't gonna pay you in a certified check, you Yankee numbskull.
Ain't childbirth just the most beautiful miracle? On earth. Seems a lady can birth monkeys, after all.
Hop on. I'll fill you in on the way.
No, I'm driving.
Fine. All right, let's get this over with.
Can we just get to the Gray's place? Let's go.
You was quiet in there.
Took everything I had. That son of a horse. I'll shove that silver spoon down his throat and pull it clean out of his arse. The smug fucker.
Okay. So what's she got us doing at the Gray's place?
She wants us to torture tobacco fields. Said they ain't had rain in weeks round here.
What?
Yep. Using that back there.
Moonshine?
Burns faster than kerosene, that stuff. Said it'd be fitting she did. All I'm thinking is how about I try fitting my boot up your hook now, you snotty old bitch.
Jose really picked the right fella for tea at the manor, didn't he?
Ah, he was giving his usual flannin. One of these families got gold stashed somewhere, he reckons. I mean, I'm all for sticking it to rich folks. I hate rich folks. There really better be some bloody money at the end of all this.
Jose knows what he's doing.
Does he, though? The master finagler of nothing.
Easy, easy.
So far, we've destroyed the Braithwaite still. Tried to sell the shine back to them. Now we're on this fool's errand, which I'm very much looking forward to, by the way. They were saying old man Gray's double security after that business at the saloon.
So, we're just gonna drive on in there, is that it?
Don't worry, I got a plan. Wagons go in and out of there all the time with supplies, equipment, payroll. Especially now they're taking on all that extra muscle. We're making a delivery, that's all. Just leave it to me. I can talk a dog off a meat wagon.
All right, then. Yeah.
You
not worried about them Grays?
In what sense?
Well, they knows you.
Yeah, maybe you're right. You know what? Here, I'll go hiding back. If you can act naturally and stop us from getting into a fight before we're ready.
I will try.
Yes. Try and do an impression of a human being.
I'm not going to go that far.
Here, stay out of sight. I'll do the talking.
Hey, hold him right there.
What you want, boy?
There was a thing at the saloon.
What you talking about?
Well, I'm delivering the supplies.
You're not the usual driver.
You want a bottle, friend? Here. Have a wee drop. I'm new. I mean you no harm. I've come from Donegal, in Ireland.
You don't say?
Yeah. They said you'd understand some kind of incident at the saloon in town. I was told to bring this up here. Ask no questions, I'll tell you no lies. Sort of business. Before the officials got there, they said.
Okay. Drive this way. I'll show you how to get there.
Oh, thank you, friend. Have a drink. Sean.
Hamish.
Good to meet you, Hamish. Fine bit of country you've got here. Not as fine as Connemara, but fine nonetheless.
My people come from Scotland.
Is that right?
head.
You and I are nearly brothers.
Just over here. Straight down the path here. It's getting so I can barely keep track of all these deliveries coming in.
Yeah, and they said they was looking for more drivers in town. I jumped at the chance. I never been a feller to kick a bit of honest work out of bed. So, you folks been having a hard time of it, have you?
Yeah, Mr. Gray's got a heap of problems right now with another family around here. Bunch of covetous lowdowns trying to sabotage his livelihood. Disgusting.
Oh dear, I'm sorry to hear that, Hamish. Sounds like you definitely deserve that drink.
You don't know the half. Just in there.
Right there.
You can unload it here.
In here? Oh, the horse is like a swift one, do they?
Excuse me?
Nothing. It's grand. Quite a place you boys have got here. Reminds me of one of them big houses out in Donegal. Huh. Real fancy places they was, Hamish. Real fancy. Because if some folks got all the money, they can build quite the fanciest places imaginable, eh? Mm. Well, we can hold up in here till it gets dark.
How you getting on?
Good. Nearly got these things ready.
Okay. There's plenty of guards out there. Here's how I feel we should deal with things. You head over to the dry barn.
Sure. And you?
I'm gonna deal with the fields themselves. We coat everything in moonshine, and then we light things up with these little fellas here. Thankfully, it ain't rained, and that old barn over there should go up like a torch.
How many of these boys you think you need?
They should do it. Let's head out the back. Look, once they get wind of us, there'll be no turning back, so move quickly.
Of course. I'm rebel stock, boy. I was bar burning down manor houses.
We'll burn quietly.
Quiet. There's someone coming on the left.
Oh, hey. Well, I thought the wagon already arrived.
This one didn't.
Strange. So, what you got there?
Tools, payroll.
Okay. Drop it by the supply shed at the back of the fields.
Sure. See you later.
You hear that? Payroll.
Yeah. Let's get this job done first, okay?
I'll take care of this fella. You douse the fields, I'll meet you at the barn.
Try to stay out of trouble. That's good for you. Thank you. That's good.
I'm gonna douse this too. Must have something with a flame, right? I'll give you 4 stunners. Woo-hoo! Would you look at that? Now let's go light yourselves a fat cigar.
Somebody shoot him already!
I'll deal with these guys. Keep warning.
This is a goddamn mess.
Hell, you got me angry.
Lord! There goes our ride out of here!
The wagon we saw come in earlier. We can nick the horses from that.
All right, where is it?
This way! Shit!
All of the bastards!
Is that all you got? Stay with me! Jesus! There's more of them!
Say you better get us paid real well for this.
Bloody right! You break what you got! Down this way! This is what it's all about! Oh, Arthur!
Glad you're having fun.
No way out of here!
Let's go!
Just get out of here first.
I think we lost them.
That we did.
Quite a night.
Sure.
Interesting little fight Dutch has put us into the middle of here.
I hope him and Jose are right and that there's some money at the end of it.
Well, what now?
Head on back to camp.
You coming?
Sure.
Cool.
Arthur. Arthur.
What now? You sweating yet, Dutch?
Of course I'm sweating. We're in some disease-ridden, swampy, Dixie-whistling shithole.
I meant about what Trelawney said about these bounty hunters.
Well, not sweating as such, but maybe a little gentle perspiration. Until we know more, ain't too much harm in wasting good liquor on sweating.
So?
So, I think you should pay Mr. Trelawney a visit and find out exactly what he knows and who he spoke to. Take Charles with you. Oh, the sight of the pair of you would make a statue sing out its secrets.
Okay. Charles, I need you for some business in town. Come on.
Okay.
Dutch wants us to have a talk with Trelawney about these bounty hunters who are coming for us. Hoping he can tell us who they are or where they're coming from.
Okay. And you're deputies now.
Something like that. As soon as we laid eyes on that fool of a sheriff who runs that town, I knew Dutch was gonna play him like a fiddle.
On the run from one bunch of lawmen, working for another. Interesting.
Hiding in plain sight, Dutch calls it.
So, spirits seem good. In the new camp, I mean.
We got some space between us and that mess now. Ain't seen no more Pinkertons for a while. There's these bounty hunters, of course, but Dutch don't seem too worried about it.
Can't believe they're still coming after us.
We didn't even get away with the money!
Yeah, but they don't know that.
Someone got here first.
So it seems.
By the looks of things, it wasn't a social call.
Check the house.
This food's barely touched. Looks like he left in a hurry.
You see anything there? What do you think? Found anything? Big struggle. Pretty recently, I'd say. I guess maybe 12 hours ago.
But no body?
Not yet. Look. Tracks. Come on.
Let's go, boy.
They went down the path here. How's your tracking these days?
All right, I guess.
Well, lead the way, then.
Not the kind of place I'd expect to see Trelawney staying in.
No?
Normally scams himself into the best hotel in town.
You know, when me and Javier went down with Trelawney to get Sean, after the bar fight, come on, we gotta stick together. Now, I was saying...
Where? He talked the whole way and never actually said a damn thing.
Excuse me.
Yeah?
Have you seen him? We're looking for our friend.
I don't think he's here.
You seen a strange sort of feller? Sort of formal?
Strange? Sure. Formal? Nah.
He uses a cane. Looks a lot like this one.
Yeah. All right, you two.
Where the hell is he?
You both better get out of here.
Come here!
It's Trelawney.
I don't know anything.
Tell me where he is.
You go to hell.
You better tell me now, you son of a bitch.
Okay. Okay, for Christ's sake. They took him to a cabin. Over by the cornfields.
Which cornfields?
Left. Down the path there by Braithwaite Manor.
All right, that should do it.
Come on, let's go.
Follow me. I think there's a way around so we don't have to go through the Braithwaite's place.
Yes. I've spent enough time there. After you, then.
Yeah!
Easy. You okay?
I'm good.
What do you think they want with Trelawney?
Could be any one of 100 things. Just depends if any of them involve us.
You think he'll talk?
Of course he'll talk. He'd sell his own sister to save a train fare. He don't know how not to talk. He don't know where we're holed up, though. At least I don't think he does.
I don't know why Dutch still deals with him. Always disappearing for weeks on end.
He's got his uses, and, well, loyalty matters to Dutch.
Of course. But is Trelawney loyal?
Yeah, kind of. I guess Trelawney ain't exactly disloyal. Just got a big mouth. Don't worry. If he talked, I'll goddamn find out what he said. Nothing's ever straightforward where Trelawney's involved. Learn that much.
I mean, how much time have we wasted getting this fool out of trouble?
He somehow manages to be both lucky and unlucky at the same time.
That's one way of looking at it.
But he always finds some way to pay us back. Just when we think about cutting him loose, he brings us something big. I guess that's his special talent. Keeping fish on the line.
That must be it.
Let's get you out of here. Come on, boy.
The thing is, after that shack, this will be remembered like a good time.
Put the man down, gentlemen. Is that the lot of them?
I think so.
So you're alive?
Allegedly.
Well, don't worry, they won't be for much longer.
Okay, go get them, Arthur. I can handle this.
Go deal with them, my brothers.
Don't let them get away. Could have told them anything.
They've gone into the cornfields. We need to flush them out. We need to find these bastards.
Here, Kay. I will find you, bastards.
They're gonna get away. Let's find them.
Stop hiding, you cowards!
You're making a big mistake!
You wait till I find you! Damn these sons of bitches.
You made a big mistake messing with us.
Where the hell are We got one more, Charles.
Look at the birds. Go that way. I see something on the ground over here.
He's dumped his gear. Look around. He can't have gone far.
He's mine!
Let me take him. You get out of here.
You have my friend.
He's not your friend. I'll give you money.
Be quiet. Come on.
You should have taken the money.
I know. I'm a fool.
Shit. Thank you.
The gunshots are coming from that bomb.
Son of a bitch got me.
Let's go back for Trelawney. You all right?
Yeah. Never goes easy, does it?
Sure don't. Come on. Let's go see how badly they beat up the slippery feller.
I wonder how much trouble he's brought with him.
Guess we'll soon find out.
Seems like we can't catch a break now, Arthur.
Our luck's hit. Well, this long, we got out of worse scrapes than this one.
So I heard.
Sure. What's government agents and bounty hunters to us?
I hope you're right. I thought you wanted to get out of here.
Mr. Trelawney, where are you?
Over here, dear boy.
Well, he's still here at least. Put your feet up, why don't you?
You okay?
Never finer.
So, who was they?
They were bounty hunters. Attached to Cole Stoudemire.
Okay.
They weren't looking for me, per se.
What'd you tell them?
Not much. I told them I was an intellectual. Come down here from Oregon, looking for a job at the university. Of course, they didn't believe me. Seems you stirred up quite a hornet's nest in Blackwater.
So I keep hearing.
It might be best if I stay with you, gentlemen, for a while. Can't go back to that caravan now.
All right, Charles. You take Trelawney back to camp. I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
There always seems to be more. More and more civilization. I want to get back in the open country of the West, or what's left of it, but... Well, even that ain't the way I remember it.